This conference will now be recorded.
Yes, now, we will discuss about set data structure, guys. Okay, set data structure. Set data structure, right? Data structure, guys. Yes, fine. Now, what is a set? What is a set? Now, all of you observe. The string is a collection of characters, all of right, collection of characters enclosed by which one, guys? Enclosed by quotes, right? Enclosed by quotes, guys, like this. Enclosed by quotes, maybe single quotes, double quotes, you can use triple quotes also. Next, list. What is list here? List is a same collection of elements or items. Okay, elements are items, guys. Items here enclosed by which one? Enclosed by square brackets. And the above quotes are mandatory. Here square brackets are mandatory for the list. Next, what is tuple? Tuple is a collection of elements or items enclosed by parenthesis. And here they are optional, guys. Parenthesis are optional. And the difference between list and tuple, yesterday we have seen, right? Right. Next one, the fourth one is a set, guys. Okay, set. Now what is a set? Set is a which one? Collection of same, guys, collection of elements or item enclosed by parenthesis, guys. Sorry, curly braces. Enclosed by, right, curly braces. All of you observe, the set is enclosed by curly braces. And here the curly braces are mandatory. Yeah, the curly braces are, you know, mandatory, guys. They are mandatory, right? Fine. Here we'll discuss very clearly how the set is different from the list and tuple, guys. And here we know the difference between list and tuple, we know very well. Now we'll see very clearly how the set is different from list and tuple, that we see. Okay, all the points one by one, guys. We'll see all the points one by one. First of all, what is set? Set is a collection of elements or items enclosed by, okay, curly braces. Curly braces, guys. If I take the supposed list, guys, list elements are there. Suppose 10, 20, 30, some 40, something A, for example, guys, like two like that. So here each element has index numbers. Each element has index number. It supports all of observing words, both forward, backward, all of, right? So all of observing here, it has index numbers, okay? Like zero onwards, all index numbers forward, right? Then backward, minus one onwards. So backward indexing is there. Same tuple also, guys, okay? So the list has index numbers, list elements index numbers. By using index numbers, you can fetch the specific element. Fetching specific element, or also you can fetch a set of elements, guys, collection of elements. If you fetch a specific element, is called indexing. If you fetch collection of elements, is called slicing, guys, okay? Index and slicing. All of you can perform both indexing and slicing because of index numbers here. Because of index numbers, right? But guys, in case of set, set elements doesn't have index numbers, guys. The set does not support index numbers. The set does not support index numbers, means like no 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, or no minus 1, minus 2, no, guys, no index numbers for set elements. If no index numbers, we can't fetch a specific element by index number, right? Because index numbers are not there, we can't fetch specific one. That's why the set does not support indexing and slicing, guys. Slicing with a single colon, with double colon, those all will not support in the set. Why? Because of simple reason. What is reason? The set elements don't support indexing or index numbers case. Okay. Now all of you observe. Yes. What's the point here? Yes. So set elements or items don't support index numbers, guys. Does not support indexing and slicing, guys. These two are not possible here in set. And the main point here is set does not allow duplicate elements, guys. That is the main point here. Doesn't allow duplicate elements. Suppose if you give one time 10, the second time 10 is not possible. Only unique elements, guys. The set allows only unique elements only, not the duplicate elements. All of right. And also one more point is there. The insertion order, guys. Insertion order of set elements is not preserved, guys. Okay, is not fixed. Means the order is not fixed, guys. The insertion order is not preserved or not fixed. Okay, these two points are most important. There's no duplicates and also no order. I'll show an example, guys. I think this is our example, right? In the previous class, guys. Okay, on Saturday class. Right. Suppose one string, guys. I'll compare all. I'm taking first P, Y, T, H, O, N. That is what order I'm giving, guys. I'm giving the order. I'm going to print it now. We'll see whether the same order is there or not. P, Y, T, H, O, N. The result also P, Y, T, H, O, N means the insertion order same fixed, guys. Okay, the insertion order is fixed, means the order not changed, guys. Right. And also I'll take one more string with my name, guys. For example, like this, N-A-R-A-Y-A-N-A. okay, N-A, guys. Now you can observe, all of you observe here. Yes, so here the string has a duplicate characters. Yeah, how many A's are there? 4 A characters are there and 2 N characters are there. The string allowed duplicates and also order, guys. Same order of characters, order not changed. That's the list string. Take the one list. I'll take some elements here. I take some elements, guys. 10, 20, 8 through 30, like this. Okay. Now I am going. Let me take the duplicates also. I'll take the list again with the duplicates also. I'll take 10, 20, again 10, like that. I'm taking duplicates also. Yes, now print off LST list. Now all of you observe, guys. So here you see, right? So how many 10s are there? 3 10s are there. Means it allows duplicate values. And see 20s also, 2 20s are there. The same time, whatever order I given while creating the object, the same order of elements, guys. Means the list also, it allowed duplicate values and also order is fixed, guys. Duplicates are there and our order is fixed. Okay, that is the case of list, guys. Now coming to tuple, I'll take same 10, 20, 10, 30, 10, like true. Then I'll take some Python like this, guys. That's fine. So duplicates are there. I'll take one more true also if you want. Yes. Now print of T, guys. Okay, I'm taking now. I'll take here print of T, right? Tuple, guys. Yes. Now all of you observe here. You can see, right? Again, same order came as it is, the input output. And also you can see duplicates, guys, right? See, three tens are there. and two true element, two characters are there, true values, all of right. Now we're coming to our main point, set, guys. I'll take the one set s equal to curly braces of, I'll take some 10 20 10, all of yams are true. I'll take some 30, again 40, again 20. I'll take again some true like this, guys. I'm taking the duplicates. Now, all of yams are, all of yams are, I'm going to print it now. I am going to print, guys. Yes. If you observe, while creating the object, my first element is 10, guys. Right? But where is the 10 here? The first 10 is not there. Where is 10? Somewhere in the middle 10 is there, guys. All of right. In case of tuple, first 10 element is there, and the result also first 10 only is there. The last one, right? The last one, which one? Bool value is there, same in the result also. Bool value last one means the same order came as it is, guys. In case of tuple, list set, list and string, that happens. In case of a set, what is happening here? See, the first element 10 came in the middle somewhere, guys, and second element 20 are given, but they came in the which one again, second position, guys. Here again, I have given the true in fourth position, but it came in the first position, guys. First position, I given the 40 in around the sixth position, it came in the third position, guys. All of observe means here, no duplicates, all of right. Here, duplicates are not there, and also order not fixed, guys. Order not fixed, all of right. So no duplicates and order not fixed, guys. Order not fixed. So no duplicates means you can say that unique, right, guys? Unique, all of right. No duplicates means what you say? You say that unique values. And no order means an order, guys. Okay, an order, unique, an order, guys. Unique and an order. So say that now a set is a collection of unique and another elements, guys. This is the excellent definition for the set. Instead of saying simply set is a collection of elements, you can say unique is a set is a collection of unique and another elements, guys. Another elements. All of you are clear these 2 points, fourth and five points, guys. I can say that
yes, set is a
collection of unique and unordered, guys. Unordered elements, unique unordered elements. Set is a collection of unique and unordered elements, guys. Okay, so unique means no duplicates. Unordered means the order is not fixed, guys. The order is not fixed. Okay, now let us see whether the set supports concatenation and multiplication or not. Let us see now whether set supports concatenation or not. I'll take S1. I'll take now S1, okay? S1, all of you, S1. I'll take 1 comma 2 comma 3, right? S2 I'm taking here, S2, something, right? 2 comma 1 comma 4 comma, like this. Then S1 plus S2. S2. Now, all of you observe, guys. All of you observe. See, it's saying that we cannot apply plus operator between two sets, guys. Set and set. Means we cannot concatenate two set objects. All of right. Now, coming to the multiplication, S1 into 2, guys. Multiplication also not possible. All of right. Okay. See, we can see it's saying that. The plus operator is not possible between set and set. The right multiplication operator not possible between set and set, guys. Means finally what you say, the set does not support concatenation, does not support multiplication, right? Multiplication. Now all of you observe set does not support concatenation and multiplication. Okay, multiplication, guys. This one we have seen just now. Then what about packing and packing, sir? What about packing and packing? Yes, guys. All of you observe. I'll take the some S1, guys. Some S1. I'll take some elements here, like 10, 20, 30, 10, 20, 10, some 40. Because guys, always I can take, you know, duplicate elements. Maybe homo or hetero, no problem. All of right, it may be homo or hetero, no problem, guys. You can take as a homogeneous elements, heterogeneous, no problem. Right. Now this is fine. In S1, how many are there? There are 5 elements, guys. After removing the duplicates, 5 are there. At a comma b comma c comma d comma e equal to s1, guys. It's called one, guys. Unpacking. Now what is a what is b what is c and what is d and what is e, guys. All of you, the set supporting unpacking the elements. Next sub, I'll take some a equal to, guys. I'll take some true, some b equal to, let's take false, some c equal to, let's take 10, d equal to, let's take 100, guys. I'll take e equal to, again I'll take the true, I take the true, some f equal to, let's take the again 100. I'm doing duplicates, okay. My S1 equal to set of A comma B comma C comma D comma F, right? Then what is S1? What is S1? All of you observe, guys. So there are 2 true values are there, right? But only one is taken, because guys, A is the true and E is the true. Both are true, so it is taken only one element, right? Next, only one false is there, that is B, right? B false, guys. I've taken the B in the second position, but the false came in the first position, guys. Okay, the variable second position, variable value came in the first position, right? First position, guys. And what is C? C is the 10, unique, right? Unique value, guys. I take the C third position, okay? The C value 10 also, third position, guys. And next, fourth one D and sixth one F, guys. That D and F value 100 came here. All of right. So finally, what we say here? We say that it supports both packing and unpacking, right? Set supports, guys. Supports both packing and unpacking the elements. Okay, unpacking, guys. Unpacking the elements. Elements are items, guys. Now, see, list is a dynamic. Set is a tuple is a static. What about the see, guys? Why list is called dynamic? All of you, why list is called dynamic object? All of you. List is called dynamic, guys? Why list is called dynamic?
Because our list is mutable.
So yes, list is mutable. That means we can add the new elements, remove the existing elements, right? But adding purpose, some functions are there for removing, some other functions are there in the list. Same, guys. Set also set is a dynamic, guys. Dynamic object, right? And mutable, guys. Mutable object. So it is a dynamic and a mutable object, guys. Enough, right? So it is which one? So it is a dynamic object and also mutable object. So I hope you understand, right? What is the meaning of dynamic? Understand now. What is the meaning of mutable? You understand, guys, already. Now, how to make dynamic means which functions we use to add the elements, to remove the elements, those we'll discuss very clearly. All of right. Next one, guys, coming to ninth point, right? See, guys, for example, list is there, right? One list is there, a tuple is there, or a string is there, anyone. Okay, there are some duplicate values, guys. Okay, some duplicate values are there in the set, in the list like that. There are some duplicates values, guys. Now I want to remove duplicate values values from where? From the string or from the list or from the tuple. How to delete the duplicate values or elements or characters from these objects by using set, guys. By using set, you can say by using set function. All right. By using set function, we can delete the duplicate elements of these all three objects, guys. So say that set is also used to remove the duplicate elements from other objects. All right. Set is also used to remove the duplicate characters or duplicate elements from the other objects. Other means you can take string, list, tuple, or set, guys. I'll show you practically all these things. Okay. Now what we say here, set is also set is used, guys. Set is used to delete the duplicate, guys. Duplicate elements. Okay. Elements or items. From other objects, guys. From other objects. What are other objects? Like a string, a list, a tuple, a set, a tuple, guys, like that. All of right. Okay. Yes. Next one. Now I can say that set can be created in different ways, guys. Okay. Different ways. What's the first way? So by using curly braces. The second one, guys, by using a set function, guys. By use set function, any other way is there, guys? Any other way is there to create a set? Any other way is there, all of you, anyone? So we use the curly braces, we use set function to create a set, guys. To create set. All of right. So just now we have seen how to create a set by using curly braces. All of right. Just now we have seen creating set by using curly braces. Now we'll see creating set by using set function. Now set of, I'll take suppose 10, 20, 10, 30, 40, 10 like that. I'll take one variable called S1, guys, right? S1. Yes, same, right? Set expecting one argument, but how many given? 6, guys. See, if you observe, in case of list function, while creating the list, in case of tuple function, while creating tuple, in case of set also, while creating a set, it's throwing the same type of error, guys. It's saying that the object takes only one argument, but given n number of arguments. Then here, I want to make all as one argument. Then what can we do? Generally, we used previously square brackets, right? Now, all of you observe, yes. I am taking now S1, guys, okay? S1, right? See. So, how these values are changing means randomly, guys. Randomly, they keep on change the positions. All of right? They keep on change their order randomly. Okay, this is the way creating set by using set function, guys. By use set function. Now I'll show you this one. Which one? Set is used to delete the duplicate elements. Duplicate elements from the which one? Other objects. Suppose, guys, one string is there. All of you observe that one string is there. Or else, let's take one list, guys. That one list is there. In the list, some elements are there. Right? Some elements, guys. Some duplicate elements are there. Okay, some duplicates elements are there like that, right? Now what I want here, I want to delete the all duplicates from the list, guys. And I don't know where are the duplicates, but the list has duplicates, guys. But I don't know on which position duplicates are there. And what I want now, I want a unique list, unique elements, like only 110, 120, 130, 140 like that. Only one, guys. Then so we use set of LST, guys. Set of LST. It's saying that set expecting only one argument, right? But 6 given. And the set, how many arguments are there? Yes, guys, only one argument is there in the set, right? I'll take one variable, something x equal to, guys, x equal to. Now, so if I print x, if I print the x, then that x is the list or set, guys. That x is the list or set. That x is the list or set, all of you. Is it the list or set? It's converting, right? Converting one into set. So that's why the now the x is a set, guys. Set of 10, 20, 30, like that. Set. But actually, what I want now, my input list, I want the output also list format only with unique values, guys. All of it. My input is the list. I want the output also list only with unique values. There, what do we do? Now, all of you observe, take the again list, right? Now set of rate LST, set of LST. Now if what does it do? It converts into set format. Into set format, right? After converting, I'll take directly here list format, guys. I want directly list format. List format like that. All of right. So that list going to set again going to list, guys. Again it list. Now take the sum x equal to then print of x, guys. Of x we can see now, all of right. So here the input is the list, guys. Input is the list with duplicate values. Now output also list with unique values, guys. For this purpose, what we have done now, we used the set function, and set function we applied which one again, list function, guys. We applied the list function also, list function also. That is the case of which one. List, right? Now same, guys, tuple also same as it is. Take the tuple of, I take 1, 2, 1, 3, 4 like that, guys. Okay, I'm taking a lot of elements like this, like this, okay, or 4 like this. Now so set of t, now set type will come, right? Now I'll take the tuple of, guys, tuple of this set. Now I'll take one variable something some y equal to, guys. Okay, y equal to, then print of y. Now all of you observe, guys, here all of you observe. So only one came, 1-2 came, 1-3 came, 1-4 came, 1-5 came, guys. So here we use list set function, we use the set function, guys. Why? To convert the list into the list with duplicate values into the list with unique values, guys. Here also the tuple with the duplicate values into tuple with unique values, guys. Unique values means to get the unique values from the any object which has the duplicate values, then we use set function. We use a set function, guys. Okay, set function. And now all of you observe one more thing, the set has its own unique functions, guys. The set has some unique functions, guys. Set functions are there. These are all not about that length counter, no, guys. Set has own unique functions are there. If you remember, I think, guys, in our school days or plus two, we get some set functions, right? Unique function, union function, intersection function, all of right. If you don't remember the logic also, no issues, guys. At least remember the names. Names are remembered or not? All of right. I think in 9th class, 10th standard, we get these functions, guys. I don't remember the exact class name, but we get it, right? So what are the set functions here? Now, all of you observe, union is one function. Union, guys. Union is the one function. Okay, next one is intersection is the one another function. Intersection, guys. The third one is the difference function is there, guys. Difference. The fourth one is symmetric. Okay, symmetric difference, guys. Symmetric difference function is there. Then the fifth one is okay. Intersection update function, guys, right? Update. Then the sixth one is difference update function is there. Then the seventh one is symmetric difference update, guys. So these are the sum of the set functions in the Python, guys. Set functions the Python. All of right. So these are the set functions. Normally regular functions are there, like length function, you know, max function, min function, sum function. These are regular functions are there, guys, in the set. All of right. Now here, see guys, in case of set, so no indexing, no slicing. Right. Next one, we have seen concatenation, multiplication. We have seen just now. We have seen packing and unpacking. We have seen already. All right. We will see how to make how set is dynamic and mutable object. Okay. And we have seen this ninth point also, which one delete the duplicate values from the other objects. Okay. Yes, guys. Before seeing this one, mutable and dynamic object, we will see some of the irregular set functions, guys. Irregular set functions. Once those functions over, we will see these functions, guys. Okay. Suppose the length function, guys. Length function we know. So all of let me know what is the use of length function, guys. What is the use of length function, all of you? What is the use of length function, all of you? Right. So to find the number of Navarjuna, please give reply chat box.
Using one
okay. Fine. Now all of you observe. Yes. I'll take one set, guys. I'll take some elements like this. Now I want to know the number of elements, unique elements available in the set, guys. How many are there? Five unique elements are there, right? Set function over. Next, count function, all of you observe, count function and index function. Okay, so why do we use count function, guys? Generally, why do we use count function, all of you? Let me know. Why do we use count function, guys? All of you. Yes, to count a number of occurrence of a specific element, we use right count function. Now I'll take same set I'm taking there. I take s dot count of 10, guys. Count of 10. Now what is the result, all of you? S dot count of 10, what is the result, guys? All of you. Count of 10. See, visibly there are two tens, right, guys? Two tens are there. But logically, in there, so many tens are there. Unique values are only one ten, guys. Okay. As output here, one, guys. One. Right, I'll take now 20. Then, guys, count of 20. Then, how many are there? 10, 20 is all of how many are there? All of you, how many 20s are there, guys? Yes, only one, right? How many 50s are there, guys? How many 50s are there? All of you. Yes, you are saying the answer one, right? You are saying the answer one, guys. Okay, how many hundreds are there, guys? Here, how many hundreds are there? How many hundreds are there? All of you, how many are there? Yes, guys, zero. How many true values are there, guys? How many true values are there? How many are there? Yes, guys, okay, zero means. See, here your answer is either one or zero, guys, right? All of you. In case of this count function on the set, your answer is either one or zero. If element is available, your answer is one, blindly one. Element is not available, blindly answer is zero. All of clear, right? If your element is available in the list, in the set, then answer is the one. If the element is not available, then answer is a zero. You can say directly, all of right. So here always answer is one only. Always answer is one. If the element is available, there's no possibility of like a two, right? No possibility of two, no possibility of four, no possibility of six, guys. Only one always. That's why. So here the count function not required. I'm asking you, hey, in my set 100 elements are there, but how many are there? One only. If I say that in my set has true values, but how many truths are there? One only. I'm saying that in my set NTH string values are there. How many times is there? One time only. So for that one, we don't need a count function all, guys. We say blindly because the set has no duplicate values. That's why the set does not support count function. The set does not support count function, guys. Okay, you can observe here. See, set object has no count function. Why? Because no duplicates are there to count. Only unique values are there. Then what do you count there? All of it. If duplicates are there, you can count it, right? Only one value is there. Then what do you count there? That's why the set has no count function. Next one, guys. I'll take the again the same list. I'll take the same for same set. S dot index index of index of suppose I'll take 20, guys. Index of 20. Index of 20. In this case, what is the answer? All of you. Error. If error, why error, guys? Actually, here, see. Do we know? While giving the data, I take 20 in second position, means index number one, guys. But it changes the position randomly, so we don't know where is 20. We don't know where is 20. That's why the set does not support index function also. The set does not support index function also. All of clear, right? So finally, we say that the set does not support count function, does not support index function. Why? Why is the question, guys? All of right, these are the simple and tricky question interview, guys. Python interview, this concept is more important data structures, but here no complex logics questions, guys. The simple questions are why set does not support the count function, why set does not support index function, like that. Okay, next one. I take the same set. Then max of yes, guys. Okay, max of yes. What's max value? Then I'll take here min of, guys. Min of yes. So min value is there. Then sum of yes. Then all of yes. All of right. Actually, we have seen all function, any function, right? Any of yes. Any of yes, all of you. I'm not going to give again n number of examples about all any, guys, because yesterday we have seen so many examples about all and any. If you have anyone still confusion is there, suppose you can see the previous video, guys, once. All of clear, right? Okay, fine. Now let us see here what functions we use to add the elements to the set. And what functions we use to remove the elements from set? Why? Because what is set, guys? Set is a dynamic object, right? Set is a dynamic object, guys. That means there are some functions compulsorily to add the elements to remove the elements, guys. Okay, to remove the elements. For adding purpose, we use add function, guys. We use add function, only add function only. Why this function? To add a new element to the existing set. That's it. For deleting elements from the set, we use the remove function, guys, and also we use the discard function, guys. Discard, remove, and discard by functions. All of you. So we use the remove function, discard functions. Why? To delete the elements, guys. Okay, delete element from the existing list. Okay, existing set, guys. existing set guys. All of clear, right? So we use add function to add the elements. We use remove and discard functions to remove the elements. All of you. Okay. Right. Let us see now how to use the add function. Let's take one set equal to some 10, 20, 30, 10 guys. Now, s dot add of I am giving 10 guys. All 10 is there. I am giving one more 10 now. Is it possible, all of you? Let me know. Is it possible? All of you. All 10 is there, right? 10 is there. I am giving one more 10 now. One more 10 now. Is it possible, all of you? Yes, guys. Okay. It's possible because it's possible, but it doesn't take the value. Why? All 10 is there, right? 10 is already. So what does it do? First of all, take that 10 and check here. Any duplicate is there? Yes, all 10 is there. It won't take. Okay, next one, guys. Now what do I do? S dot add off. I'll take the 100, guys. I'll take the 100. Okay. Yes, it will add, guys. It will add until position. Which position, guys? It will go to the first position. So here, don't think that okay, always you go to first position. No, guys. Again, the new value can add maybe in the beginning, maybe in the middle, maybe in the end, guys. Anywhere it can add randomly. Randomly, the value will changes, guys, and also it will add the new values. And can we add multiple values by add function, guys? Can we add multiple values? I'll take here, suppose square boxes. I'll take suppose 5 comma, some 6 comma, something like this, guys. Trying to add multiple values. It's saying that type error, unhashable type list, guys. Means so here now what is happening? Add of list. Not taking, right? Not taking, guys. I'll take the tuple type. All observe now. Let's see tuple type, guys. Yes. Right? Now, what is the yes? Right? Now, tuple, guys. Tuple added. Means in the set, it is not taking the list, but taking the tuple, guys. Why? Because tuple is a immutable object where you cannot perform the any modifications, guys. All are clear, right? See, this type of simple objects required, guys, in entire use. Okay, right. Now, but guys, here even though I had taken 679, but all came as a one element, right? All came as one element, guys. All came as a one element, not multiple elements, guys. Not multiple elements. All of you observe here, right? So the add function is not taking the list of values, it is taking the tuple of values only. So what is unhashable, sir? That we'll see later, guys. Hashable, unhashable, two types are there. Hashable, unhashable, that we'll see later about this one. Okay, it is allowing a tuple of elements, guys, because tuple is a which one immutable object which is not allowing modifications. All of right, okay. Fine. This is the way adding the element, guys. Adding the element to the existing set by using add function. Guys. Now coming to the which one the remaining which one remove and discard functions, guys. Discard functions. All of you observe. Yes. What is the list? 2, 50, 20, 10, 30, right? 10, guys. Now, all of you observe. List data remove of 10. 10 is available, right? 10 is available, guys. 10 is available. So if element is available, it will remove the value, guys. What is the list now? Because I'm taking the name LST. You can take any name, guys. It's not a predefined names, right? Any name, okay. Then LST, guys. What is that one? Yeah, list is set name, guys, not list. List is set name, okay? See, guys, right? Actually, here initially 10 is there. 10 is there. Now, set that remove of 10, that 10 is removed because 10 is there. Suppose, guys, I'll take now list dot remove of, I'll take here 100, which is not available, guys. All of right. If the here element is available, that is removed. But now element is not available, 100 is not available in that set, then guys, it will throw error, which error? Key error, guys, okay? Key error, key 100, means 100 is not available. That's meaning, guys. All of right? So remove function, you will remove the value if that is available in the set, guys. That if that is not available in the set, it will throw error and key error, guys. Okay, key error. Now let's go with the all of this one clear, right? This remove function, all of you see two cases: either element is available or not available. If element is available, then that will remove. If element is not available, then error, guys. That's very simple. Now we'll take here one more object, guys. One more set with same elements, some 10, 20, 10, 30, right? Like 30, then true, like this, okay? Like this. Now, all of you observe s dot discard, guys. Discard of s dot discard of. I'm taking the 10 which is available, then the 10 will remove, guys. The 10 will remove. 10 is removed. Same remove also. If element is available, that is removing. If element is not available, and the remove, if element is not available, it is giving the key error. In case of discard, guys, in case of discard, if element is not available, then what will happen? All of right. In case of remove of 100, which is not available, at that time key error. Now discard of 100 again that is not available. So in this case, guys, the discard will not give any error. The discard will not give any error. See, guys, even though 100 is not available, but error is not there. Then what is the available? Same as it is, guys. Same as it is there. All of clear, right? See, then sir, when you go for remove and when you go for discard, sir, see, guys, if you are sure that element is available compulsorily, then you can go for anyone, guys. Go for either remove or discard when if you are damn sure that element is available in the set. Suppose you are not sure that element is available or not available, and I don't want to get error. In that case, always better option, which one, guys? Discard, because discard means if element is there, remove the element. Element is not there, then nothing, guys. No error here. In case of remove function, if element is there, remove the element. If element is not there, it will throw error. It will throw error. But in case of discard, there's no possibility of error, guys. All of clear, right? Okay. So tell me now, when you go for the remove, when you go for the this discard means if we are damn sure that element is available in the set, then at that time you can use anyone. Either we can use which one? That remove or discard, guys. Anyone, no problem. When if you are sure that element is available, if you are not sure that element is available, if you are not sure, then we go for only which one? Discard to avoid the error, guys. To avoid the error, go for which one? Discard only. Discard only. Now, all of you are clear about remove and discard functions, guys. All of you are clear about remove and discard functions. All of let me know. So here they allow only one value, guys. You can remove only one element at a time, not multiple elements. If you want to remove multiple elements, we can write our own functions, guys. These are the predefined functions. They have their own predefined logic, that's all. You can't use for our logic purpose these predefined functions, guys. They have their own functionality. If you have your own functionality, like I want to at a time four elements, two elements, or a number of elements at a time, then we create our own logic. means we create our own user-defined functions that we'll see later, guys, how to create our own functions as per our requirement. Okay. Now, all of you, till now, the set is clear for everybody. Till now, the set is clear for everybody. Till now. Still, the set is not over, guys. Still, lot of set is there. But till now, what we discussed up to here, everything is clear, right? For everyone. All of you. Yes, guys. Okay. Okay. Fine. Fine, guys. Right? So we stop it now. We stop it now. We'll continue tomorrow with same link, same time. Thank you, all of you. Thank you all. Thank you. Bye.
பதி